Yo, what is going on YouTube? It's your boy Dan, aka A-Drive. I'm bringing you guys a brand new video today, and today we are going to answer the question of whether or not the brand new Pokemon MOBA game, Pokemon Unite, is pay to win. I've seen a ton of controversy online about this topic, about people playing the game, paying a lot of money to get advantages in the game, and how that actually impacts this game moving forward. So I've done a ton of testing on a handful of different items, and I'm gonna break down every aspect of this and this discussion in this video. I encourage you to take part in the discussion as well with your thoughts after you watch the video. Check the comment section below and let me know your thoughts. And of course, be sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel if you guys are new, as I post Pokemon videos every single day. And we're gonna be throwing down a ton of Unite content, including my settings guide. Highly recommend you guys check that out, and much, much more. And last but not least, I stream Pokemon Unite every single day on twitch.tv/adrive. I would love for you guys to tune in. I've been streaming pretty much every day. I streamed 14 hours on launch, 7 hours yesterday. I'm gonna stream a lot the day this video goes up, and so on and so forth. So we're gonna break it all down for you guys in this video about whether or not we believe Pokemon Unite is pay to win. Now, obviously the game is free to play. You could download it for free, and they actually indicated when the game was first announced that it was going to be free to start. So we're gonna talk about what that means and how that impacts gameplay here. So the first thing I wanna talk about is that there are three different types of currency in this game. The first type of currency you can receive is the EOS coins. You can see I have 3,610 coins. Now this is gonna be kind of your primary currency, but I will say that this is capped to only 2,100 coins per week. That is the max amount of coins that you can earn, is 2,100 coins per week, which seems pretty low actually, if you think about that, considering how expensive it is to buy these characters. It would in theory take about 3 weeks to unlock Snorlax by that measure, 3 weeks to unlock Pikachu, and much, much more for some of these higher ranked characters. Now, full disclosure, and I'll talk about this in a little bit, I have spent money to make this video and on the game, so I'll kind of go through that in a little bit. But you can see with a max of 2,100 coins per week, very, very limited opportunities to unlock these various characters. Now, I will say you start off with a few characters. There's characters on a timed rotation, and then there's also gonna be characters that are gonna be released for free. Ninetales came out yesterday. We know that they're gonna give us Crustle for free at day 7. They're gonna give us Greninja, I believe, after week 2. So some of these characters are free. So if you haven't paid for them yet, they will come out eventually for free. And I'm sure they're gonna continue to rotate these characters out. So that's one thing I wanna mention. The next type of currency is called EOS tickets. Now, those EOS tickets can be used for a handful of different things, but they're primarily used to buy whether it be fashion items like these, or you can use them to buy held items. So you can see I can use coins or tickets to buy these different held items that I haven't purchased yet. I've got a lot of them already, but again, I highly recommend looking ahead in the battle pass and things like that to make sure that you know what you're gonna automatically unlock. Cause like I unlocked the scope lens automatically just by playing the game. And I'm not exactly sure what the rewards return is if you bought something and then they give it to you as a reward, what they're gonna give you. I'm not entirely sure. And then the last thing is the third option at the very top that I have 8 of, which is EOS gems. And that is the paid currency. And I'll show you guys an example here. If I go to pay, here, actually, let me scroll down to this because I don't have any tickets. If I go to buy 50 of these, it's gonna say I need 50 EOS gems. And it's gonna say that I need to go purchase EOS gems. And this is the breakout here for the EOS gems. And this is the premium currency. So I bought the $100 pack so far, and then I also bought, I think, the $8 pack so far, full disclosure, right? And by the way, this is not sponsored or anything. I'm giving my honest thoughts here. So you can see that I got about 7,000 gems this way. This is a one-time deal. This is a one-time deal. This is a one-time deal. So while it would make more sense to just get this 5 times, I ended up grabbing this. So this is the currency. And what this game is doing is they're using multiple layers of conversion to kind of trick or blind the player so they don't know how much every item actually costs, right? Because they'll say, okay, you can use coins, you can use tickets, and you can use EOS gems, and they all kind of convert, and you convert gems into tickets and whatever else. So there's a lot of confusion in terms of what actually equals what. But that's we'll get into that here in a bit. The one thing I want to mention before I go any further, I kind of broke down the three different types. The one thing I want to mention is on the characters. I do not feel that the character aspect of unlocking is pay to win, but I'm going to talk about items because that's really the big part here. The pay to win, it's not pay to win for the characters because you can choose to unlock a character at a very slow pace. Is it going to take a while to unlock every character? Yes, but you can choose to unlock the character you want. And ultimately, you know, I would imagine most people are going to stick to one or two characters. The practice field allows you to practice with any character, so you can try them out. I would just recommend, again, looking ahead at the characters that you want and making sure that you don't just grab a character that's going to be unlocked for free later and things like that. So just be mindful of who you unlock if you don't want to spend any money. Now, the real thing here, and this is where we're going to break down what is going down in terms of these items and how this works. So for those who don't know, you can buy, again, these energy item enhancers. These item enhancers. This is the key item right here that is why people are saying this game is pay to win. You can convert AO's gems, which is the paid currency, to buy item enhancers and get a bunch of them. So I can tell you, like I said, I spent about 110 bucks or so, $107 on item enhancers. And you can go to X and go to battle prep. You can go to your held items, and then you can actually see these different held items here. And you can take an item from level 1 all the way up to level 30. And you can see my Rocky helmet here. Look at those buffs that I receive on my Rocky helmet. I received 270 HP and almost 40 defense buff to my character by holding a level 29 Rocky helmet, which is a massive buff from a statistical perspective, looking at this character and saying, okay, wow. So you're able to get these massive buffs on your character by just paying money right now, right? Because it's gonna take a while to be able to grind all these up. I would estimate it's probably gonna take months for the average person not spending any money to get 3 items up to level 30. And I can tell you, this is about where my items are at right now, and that's with me spending $100, right? I spent 100 bucks, and you can see this is what I have. 29, 23, 20, 25, 20, 7, and then I haven't powered anything else up yet. So that's what you can roughly get. So I could have said I probably maybe get 3 items to 30 or 2 items to 30 at this point with about $100. And you can see I still have a little bit of currency, but to upgrade at this level is actually insane. I need how many gems? I need 160 of these kind of item enhancers at level 23 to keep going. So again, a massive upgrade. I would estimate that it's gonna take approximately $500 to $700 to max out every item right now. If you wanted to just spend all the money right now, max out every single item, it would take about $500 to $700 to do that. But the real question is here, how much do these items actually make a difference in the gameplay? Because that's what we're really talking about here. It's not pay to win if the items don't make a difference. So let's talk about these items and how much of a difference they make. And again, I jumped in, I did some testing, and we're gonna break that down right now. So the first item we're gonna look at is the Floatstone. And I've got this really nice side-by-side comparison that I'm gonna have my wonderful editor KG edit onto the screen. And the Floatstone is going to increase your movement speed. And that's what I was really interested to look at, is if I had a Dwebble with no Floatstone and a Dwebble with a Floatstone at level 25, how fast would I move to the point that I was getting to? So from the beginning to kind of the middle field at the top. And it gets slowed down a little bit because you kind of run into combat, but I try to follow the same path. And you can see through this example, there's about a 2-second difference between my Dwebble with the Floatstone and without the Floatstone. So this is an item and an example here that I was able to move about 2 seconds faster across the map because I essentially paid to upgrade my Floatstone, right? That's a pretty significant difference. Now, that doesn't help you in combat, but it is still a pretty significant difference. The next item I want to show you guys is the Rocky Helmet. Let's look at all the data first. Then I want to look at the Rocky Helmet. So I went at a comparison of a 0, no Rocky Helmet, no items, versus level 29 Rocky Helmet, right? I didn't quite max it. And you can see I get a massive HP buff and a massive defense buff. And this Zeraora attacked me, and we wanted to see how many hits it would take for the Zeraora at the same level to knock me out, with Zeraora having no items or any changes. And you can see it took 25 hits for the Zeraora to knock out the Crustle or the Dwebble without the Rocky Helmet, and it took 28 hits for it to knock it out with the Rocky Helmet. So me spending all that money and getting my Rocky Helmet all the way up to level 29 only made a difference of 3 hits. 3 hits from the Zeraora. That was all that made a difference. Now, to me, that is pretty minimal in the grand scheme of things. That's just my thoughts. I think that that's pretty minimal. And then the last thing I wanted to look at was the Muscle Band. The Muscle Band is an item that I actually think is very, very good. I highly recommend looking into this item. Muscle Band actually increases your attack speed. So the basic attack that you use, how fast that attack goes off, and it also gives you a slight buff to your attack. So I did the same comparison, Dwebble facing an Audino with no Muscle Band, no items, versus Dwebble facing an Audino with the Muscle Band at level 20, and we saw a difference of 14 hits without and 12 hits with. And there was a little bit of a difference movement speed. It was kind of hard to track the movement speed, but we'll try to get a good side-by-side comparison on screen to show you exactly what shook down right here. So there was a difference, a couple hits difference. The Rocky Helmet saved me from 3 hits, and the Muscle Band saved me 2 hits. The Floatstone saved me 2 seconds. And again, these are not max, but they're close. I think they're close enough for the purpose of this conversation. So ultimately, these items do give a significant advantage. I will say that. I think that if you were to have a player with no items or all items at level 1 versus a player with all items at level 30, there is definitely a significant enough advantage at level 30, especially in a game where just the slightest bit of movement to get away, just the slightest bit of damage can make the difference of a knockout, which can turn the tide of a game. Just the slightest bit of damage could be the difference between you knocking out Zapdos and someone else knocking out Zapdos. So that is very significant when we look at it in not only just one item, but really three items. Again, one hit here or there, I can kind of write off. But when we're looking at multiple hits, and this is over the span of three potential items that can be boosting your stats, not everyone is on an even playing field. I could go ahead and drop 500 bucks right now and have a massive advantage right now against the newer players who are not going to pay. The real question now sets in. How will Pokemon Unite and Pokemon and Tencent deal with the distribution of these premium currency items? They're probably not going to give away any gems anytime soon. But are they going to be giving away a lot of coins in extra events? Are they going to be giving away extra tickets? Are they going to be giving away other opportunities to get more item enhancers to allow players to upgrade their different items? We are on day three of this game coming out at the time of me recording this, and I simply think it is too early for us to understand how quickly they're going to be releasing these things. They could do a massive giveaway, login event or whatever it is next week and drop 1,000 item enhancers. I don't think they will, but they could do that. So there is that opportunity for players to catch up. But right now, people who are paying in this game are getting a significant advantage. The last thing I want to say about this, because I think that there's a caveat here. Is the game pay to win, right? Do you have an advantage? Yes. Is it pay to win? I'm not entirely sold that it's pay to win. And the reason I say that is because I believe that Pokemon Unite, and I think if you've played extensively, I've got 80 games under my belt right now, not including my beta gameplay. If you play Pokemon Unite, no amount of buffs, extra items, level 30s, whatever, is gonna make the difference between a cohesive team that is playing together and playing efficiently versus a team that's disoriented and just kind of running all over the map and feeding. I think there's a lot more to be said about playing with people who know what they're doing, playing coordinated and communicating with the team, and really fulfilling the role that you're meant to fulfill in each single match. That is really what is gonna make the difference between winning a game and losing a game. Not necessarily an assault vest at level 30 or a Rocky helmet at level 30 or any of that stuff. Will it give you an advantage? Absolutely. But is it the difference between winning and losing? Probably not most of the time, because this is a team game and there are five players on each team. So I pass the question to you guys. What do you guys think? Do you think with all the data that I've laid out, all the thoughts and all the facts we've laid out, that Pokemon Unite is pay to win? Clearly, there's a significant difference between a Pokemon holding these items at level 30 versus a Pokemon holding these items at level 1, a massive buff for the players who can pay. But how much does that actually impact the gameplay experience when you're in-game setting? I don't know. I'm going to go out on a limb and say I think we need a little bit more time to see how Pokemon Unite is going to handle these premium currencies, like these item upgrades, to see if they're going to be distributing them to players at a frequent occurrence, or if they're going to leave players high and dry and make this a game where for the non-pay-to-play character, they're gonna have to spend months and months and months to get to the same level that I can get today by spending $500. I'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments section below. I appreciate a civil discussion. Again, I'm not on anyone's side here. I'm just trying to bring you the facts and give you my thoughts and my opinions, just lay things out here. It's kind of, like I said, I don't necessarily know if from my perspective, if there's one answer or not. There's definitely an advantage here though. I don't think we can dispute that. If you guys enjoyed this video, hit that like button down below and make sure you guys subscribe to the channel if you guys are new. I appreciate you guys tuning in, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Tune into my live streams at twitch.tv/adrive, and I look forward to a great conversation in the comment section below. My name is Dan. I also go by Adrive, and I will see you guys on the next one. Peace.